Macros can really lift your programmable keyboard closer to that endgame dream, allowing you to execute a series of keystrokes with just one. That might be a string of characters or a hotkey combination for an application or a game. If you don't have any setup in QMK but are hungry to see what can be done, then part 5 of my QMK guide will satisfy your macro needs. As always, refer to the QMK docs for much more detail and some more examples of what you can do with macros. You'll set up your macros in the keymap file that we've seen in previous episodes. First, you'll define your custom keycodes so that you can refer to them later. Then you'll use the process record user function to check for presses and releases of your keycode, and send string to send the macro. You'll set a key to trigger your macro in your keymap. Now, if you can get a handle on these three basic ideas, you'll have no trouble creating your own macros. Let's look at my keymap for my new Mini. I've defined my custom keycodes here, separated by commas. Safe range is there at the top to make sure your keycodes don't conflict with those already used by QMK. Then I have my three layers, two of which have collapsed. The top row of the third layer is where my macros live. When I have this layer active and I tap that key, the macro will trigger. Down at the bottom is where I have my functions. These are really simple strings I set up when I was learning how macros worked in QMK. I've separated each one by adding a case before the name of the macro. When I hit the appropriate key on layer 3, some stuff happens. You can also use modifiers in your macros and specify if a key should be held, tapped, or released. This example will select a word and then copy it. Notice how the keycodes use X rather than KC, which we usually see in keymaps. Make sure you check the keycodes supported by send string. Also notice how tap makes this code a little shorter than having to use up and down for every key we press. So think about that when you make your macros. I'd love to make another video on macros showing what you've done with them, so let me know what macros you've set up that people might find interesting. Share your code and we might be able to have a one-off episode of This Is My Macro. See you next time.